connection and in the free software from track. Station X, encouraging women to get involved in our hackerspace. Ellen and Silje.
Yes, I'm Ellen. Should I use the microphone?
Yes, please.
Is it okay?
Okay, for the recording.
Ago, we started a women's group called Station X, and we started the group because we wanted to involve more women into our hackerspace. And the name Station X is from World War II, so the women, the female code breakers working at Bletchley Park, and their department was called Station X, so we thought it was a cool name for our women's department. And yeah, our goal for this talk is to present to you our approach and what we did with our women's group and how we think it worked out and the problems we faced or still facing. And then we have a lot of feedback from you and what you think about this, ideas, what we could change, your experiences with women's groups.
Reasons for why women might feel that hackerspaces are not for them. And first thing we came up with is the I don't belong thought that sometimes comes up, like if I go to this hackerspace meeting, will I be the only woman there? And in these situations, it can be useful to extend an extra invitation to say that, okay, if you come to this meeting, yes, there will be women there, you won't be the only one present. Not a real hacker. Sometimes, or at least in our experience, women often feel that since they started exploring computers later at a later stage, they sometimes feel that they cannot describe themselves as a hacker, they don't identify as a hacker because they haven't been doing it for long enough and they don't feel like they're an expert. And that you're so far behind that you can never truly call yourself a hacker. I will be representing all women in IT. This is something that we've at least all experienced. If we're the only woman in a room full of guys, and if we, there's this feeling that if we, you know, say the wrong thing or ask a stupid question, then that would, you know, create the impression that all women are you know, stupid question askers, and that is something that might discourage women from coming and asking questions. And the, I don't even know what a hackerspace is, how do I know if I want to join one? It's a thing that I think is not, most people don't know what a hackerspace is, but we feel that maybe it's more common among women. They don't know what it is and they don't know what to do there and the possibilities that exist when you're a member of a hackerspace.
Yeah, so what have we did to combat these problems? We are having regular meetings once a month that we call Ladies Night, like as a working title. If you come up with a better one, please tell us. So, but for now we call it Ladies Night, and we're like trying to have this as an easy entry point. So it's called Ladies Night, right? So it's for women and it's for women only. So we kind of have a safe group, a safe space, and where women can be sure that they will be welcome there. And we also found it's very helpful if you're first getting to know other women and then kind of go together to the regular hackerspace meetings and meet everyone in the hackerspace who's usually hanging out there. And we are encouraging women to join even if they don't feel they are a hacker. So we say, so if you're interested in this, if you're curious, this is enough reason to join. Just come on and see if you like this. You don't need to feel like you're a hacker or an expert or, you know, some kind of label they might not identify with. And we also thought it would be helpful to have a safe learning space because of the reason Silje mentioned that when I'm the only woman in a room full of guys, I often feel like I'm kind of representing women in general, like say women developers or whatever kind of setting this is. And then I feel okay, if I screw up, the guys will think women in general can't program. Of course, this is stupid, and maybe you male guys don't think this, or at least maybe not most of you, but it's in my head. So this Women's Night or Women Only events is also like a safe learning space where I feel like I can just be myself and I don't have to prove myself all the time. So kind of to let down my guard for a while. And yeah, we also wanted to have a support group for women working in IT and being in hackerspaces because, well, problems can arise and colleagues can be idiots and be sexist and make remarks that I'm not comfortable with and I don't know how to respond maybe. And then we wanted to have this support group to, you know, have some place where we could go and vent and ask for advice and ask other women who might be in a similar situation who have been there. Maybe they have some advice how to cope with the situation or can come up with solutions. And also very often it's just helpful to hear, yeah, you know, you're totally not the only one, I've been there too.
Yeah, so what we've tried so far is we kind of made this concept that we call passing on the ops, and it's about creating a stage to share knowledge and learn from each other. We've established regular meetings once a month. We have Ladies' Night at Hackeriet. And then we also established an IRC channel, that's Station X on Freenode. And we did some entry-level workshops. We did like an introduction to Linux, we did an introduction to IRC, SSH, Bash scripting, and we did a programming workshop also. We also tried having social events, like we had a movie night where we showed
Revolution
OS. And so, did it work? We think so. We actually have more women showing up, both to ladies' night and regular meetings. We have more women participating in our space in general, like signing up to do workshops and talks, etc. And we also have more, we have arenas now where we can share knowledge and take part in the active discussion that goes on at Hackeriet, on the IRC channel, on the mailing lists, at the meetings, and so on. And I think a good example of like a success was the Introduction to Linux workshop that we had, because it was a real feeling of women learning to and from each other. And it was a very low entry kind of introduction to what a hackerspace is.
Yeah, so the challenges we faced. So for once, it's cool to have newbie workshops or entry level workshops and talks, but obviously this attracts newbies. And to be a sustainable group, we also need to extract people who are on a level, on a higher level, who knew, say, Linux and bash scripting and programming and whatever kind of things we want to talk about or we want to play around with. And so the challenge is kind of to find topics that appeal to a broader audience, to have it all ladies' nights, and especially topics where we can that actually we also can cover, or some women we know, because we would really like to focus on having only women, women-only events. So we totally don't want to create the situation where we have a male speaker and the only female audience, because this would kind of work against our goals to also present ourselves to ourselves and everyone else and room as role models and as, hey, women can do shit too. So yeah, finding interesting topics and covering them ourselves is a challenge. And we also found that we kind of went into this adventure, maybe with a pretty close mind, or I don't know, maybe we didn't really think it through. But we found that we should really keep an open mind about what kind of participation we want. So, for instance, we had the experience that some women only want to join the ladies' nights. And at first we were like, yeah, but you know, we kind of created this space to integrate everyone in the big group. And then we started thinking and we were like, yeah, but actually, that's fine. If they just want to participate at ladies' nights, that's cool. Just come and enjoy the group and contribute. You don't have to do like everything. Right, so we kind of really want to watch out to have an open mind about what people want, and not kind of be there on top and say, hey, we should do it like this, but we'd rather have it bottom up, like hackerspaces are supposed to be. So another challenge we are facing, which kind of goes into the first one, is that it's a lot of work to start and keep the women's group going. Think about it as starting a hackerspace all over. You have the infrastructure in place, but also recruiting is a lot harder because there aren't that many women as men who are into these kind of things. So it's really a lot of work and takes a lot of energy. So this is maybe a warning if you want to do the same thing. Be aware of this. Like, don't get burnt out. Get help. Get everyone to contribute. Don't stand there on your own. Or maybe and try to make it on your own, because it won't work over time. Yeah, so finding good ways to recruit new people is also a challenge.
Yes. Future plans for Station X. We decided for next year that we won't focus so much on entry-level workshops, like Ellen said. And that to, in order to not only, you know, do cool workshops and have talks, we also want to do a bit of like community building. So we think that a mix of like more social events, or just, you know, random, just a regular, you know, hackerspace meeting, and workshops and presentations and more, you know, things happening should be like, it should alternate that you have like an event of each type every other month. And that way you can come to a workshop and learn something new, and then you can come back if you keep working on things that you learned, you can come back and ask questions and develop yourself even more. And we also decided that we want to try and reach out to first year students, not just first year students, but all of the women who are studying computer science courses, to give them a chance to have a support group, because in the beginning it can be quite difficult if none of your other friends are going through the same thing, and a good support group for students, and also trying to be role models for each other.
Yeah, so to sum it up, we started the group to get more women involved, and we think it totally worked because more women are getting involved both in the women's group and in the hackerspace in general. And they're not only showing up at the meetings, like physical space meetings, but also online, participating on the mailing list and the IRC channel. And we actually got a lot of positive feedback, both from the women who attended our events, but also from the guys, they were like a lot of, we got a lot of comments like, well, this is a really cool workshop, could you please do this for all of us? And can I please attend? What do I have to do to attend? Well, be a woman, you are not, so I'm sorry, but we can do the workshop for everyone, of course. And they also said, it kind of created a different atmosphere. And this
yes.
This was really... This was helpful what you're doing, please keep on doing it. So they accept that you're doing this group where they are not part of and see it as a part of the whole. And they acknowledge and appreciate what we're doing. So that was very good to get this feedback. And I felt that was very, very positive.
Yes. So we have some questions that we want to ask you, and that is, what are your experiences regarding women in hackerspaces? And as a woman, are you part of another type of women's group? So what we want to know is, like, what worked, what made you join, and what topics do you think would be cool and interesting to do as a part of our future ladies' nights? And also any general feedback that you may have on our approach to setting up this group is much appreciated.
And of course you can also ask questions if anything is unclear. So please.
Thanks for the question.
I have two questions.
Okay.
Just let me. Okay, so... The first one, how many women decides to visit only the ladies' night? Like, percentage, do you have any?
Yeah, well, actually, I think it was one who said that, and a couple who were there at the ladies' nights, but didn't show up yet at the regular meetings.
Mm-hmm.
But also, we heard that, so I'm not really sure about the reasons. So because we also have the impression that women have a lot more like family responsibilities and thus don't have as much time as guys. This is obviously not true for everyone, but in general. So we don't know what really the reason is. So the percentage of the women regularly showing up at the general meetings and just at the ladies' night, kind of hard to say. So the ones who generally show up, I'd say it's like 30-40% of all of the women who ever attended at least one ladies' night.
So 30-40% just attend just the ladies' night, or?
No, 30-40% are like became an active member after they first joined the women's group.
And.
But this also, I mean, the 60-70% who didn't join the general group includes also the ones who only were at the ladies' night once,
mm-hmm.
Right?
Okay.
And I think it's an ongoing thing. I think sometimes they came first to one ladies' night, and then they came to another ladies' night, and then I saw them at the regular meeting. So it might be like a process that you're going through. But we don't know, like, we don't have an interview, like, why did you come to the regular meeting? Why are you not interested in this and that? So.
And this is actually also something we see generally at new members at the hackerspace. So this is like a fairly young hackerspace. It was started in 2009, late 2009, so it's just about 3 years old. And so some people might just show up at some talk or workshop, and then don't show up for like half a year, and then be back. And maybe it takes another 3 months before they are back. So I think this is just a general thing for people joining hackerspaces. It takes some time to get to it sometimes. Or they, you know, just have other priorities in life.
Okay, and another one, so this is a tricky one. How do you begin with this kind of activity if you have no women currently in your group?
Yeah,
or if you have very small number that can't really organize it all themselves and keep track of everything?
This is actually a very, very good question. And I think if you don't have any women at all in your group, I think one thing that is really important to do is drop the labels. Like, don't say, this is hackers evening. Because people who don't identify as hackers obviously won't show up, right? So try to find a little bit more open wording. Have a lot of workshops and talks. Like, don't have like, oh, we have like a general social evening where we just hang out and do a project. Because if you don't know the group, and if you're a woman and you suspect, okay, this is like a group of guys who've been hanging around in the basement for 20 years, and now they have another basement to hang out together, why should I go there, right? So try to have like a themed evening or topic presentation, something that draws attention. This will actually not just help to get women involved, but more people in general. So give them a reason to show up. And if you already have like one or two women, like we started out just the two of us, right? So first I felt it was only me, and Silje felt it was only her, because we kind of kept missing each other. And so it took some time to get to know each other. And so you can get to know them, and maybe after a while talk to them and say, hey, this hackerspace in Oslo, they have a women's group. If you want to start something similar, you totally have our support. Tell us what you need if you need any help. Or should I provide the contact to the gods in Oslo? So that would be us, and then you can just send them to this address. And that's hackeriet.no. Yeah, I think that's my answer. Anything
to add?
Good, thank you.
I was also thinking that, yeah, if there's only a few women in the hackerspace, the guys that are involved can help out with the preparations of the meetings, so you give that support.
Absolutely.
So you don't have to form like that whole thing about them.
Should they avoid offending them or not?
Yeah. To start off with the list, if that's what you decide to do, then to have it completely all female, but can help out with the
preparation.
To just get it going.
It's very easy to accidentally grab the attention. But it's something, for example, if you know a lot about stuff, then you start talking more and more.
Yeah. I kind of disagree with you.
Okay.
About the ask the few women that are there to invite other women. Because very often, when I attend different kind of organizations, I get to be the one only woman there. And one of the most common questions are, why aren't there more women in free software? Why aren't you more of you? And it's like, I don't know. Can I please just come and be me and do whatever I want? So if you're interested in getting women into your groups, but you don't have any women who want to do the activity work, ask someone who do that. Invite these women to come and have the arranged ladies' night. Please don't force that one woman or that two women that you have into being and doing work they don't want to. Because the only thing you risk is alienating them. You can, of course, be nice and ask politely, but that's not their task.
I agree very, very much with you. Sorry, that wasn't really clear when I answered your question. But I think the important thing is to get them to know. Get to know them first.
Yeah.
And so if you know them on a bit better basis, you can talk about this kind of topics too and ask them if they want to do anything more.
Yes, and you should also ask everyone to invite women.
Yeah.
I mean, not only the women, because I know a lot of women, maybe you're the guy. I mean, everyone should invite one female or female identified friend, or one person that identifies as female, or whatever. I don't know.
No, I have no questions. I have just some statements.
Yes.
One is, I would suggest you for your workshops or for your talks on a higher, like intermediate level, perhaps you can invite some speakers from another town or. I think I would come if you invite me. So.
Okay, so please give us some means of contacting you after the talk.
Yeah, but not because I'm from Berlin, so. Once I could come once and give some workshops, so it would be not a problem. Then another what you already said, I have experience with another organization, and there's also if there are many people show up once and they never come again, it's not depends on the gender or of special of events. There are always people who want to see what's this, and then perhaps they're interested in, but they have so much another stuff to do, so. They don't come from, don't don't take it to your heart.
No, you're absolutely right.
Yeah, and then the third sentence what I want to say, it's perhaps you will not. I think it's good what you're doing, but it's in my everyday life that I'm only woman in the groups, like in the hacker spaces or my political work, what I do. And for me, I don't feel it because I'm me and I come there. So it's like I would be there, the only person with a black hair. I don't feel it. But I can understand there are other people, they feel uncomfortable, but I don't. So I don't, for me, the going to the women meeting is not so important. So I want welcoming, I thought another meeting. For me, it's more important welcoming atmosphere for beginners. Doesn't matter, there are some shy boys too. This is not a gender specific. So if it's the atmosphere, you can ask the stupid questions. And nobody loves you, then you love at you, and they just try to explain stuff to you. You feel welcome, and then you come again. I think I prefer it's open for everybody who wants to start to do stuff soon.
Yeah, thank you. So I think this is actually a very good point, and we got that as feedback too. Like, well, you know, I'm too used to being the only woman. I've been the only woman all my life. Because I've been working in IT or, you know, involved with open source software or whatever. I'm used to it. I don't even notice it anymore. But on the other hand, we also got a lot of feedback from women. This is cool. I wouldn't have joined if you hadn't done this event. So I would guess for everyone like you and also me a couple of years ago, who said, well, I totally don't even notice if I'm the only one, because I'm the only one and I see everyone looks alike and I don't see myself, right?
Yes.
So actually, that's kind of funny, because when I first started studying computer science, and I wouldn't notice if I was the only woman. But if there was just one other one, I would notice, wow, there are really not a lot of women here. Right? So I totally get your point, and there are a lot of women who feel like you, and I also did this a couple of years ago. But I think for everyone like us, there's like 3 or 5 others who don't feel this way.
There might also be some organizations, like there might be someone running Rails Girls, or in Finland, there in Helsinki area, and Tampere, there's this Nice Tuesday, which is a ladies' network. So it might be a good, nice way to find someone, if there is something similar running in the area, and then invite them for a visit. Might evoke some interest.
Good point.
But I also think that this is something that we're working on a general basis, is have an open and welcoming atmosphere at the hackerspace. It's not just on ladies' nights, it's just all the time. So, and we also try to have like a good, like a different level, like a diverse...
Yeah.
And have different kinds of workshops, you know, not only for beginners, but also for people who want to, you know, evolve and learn new stuff.
I'd like to comment a little.
I just want to say, I've been saying this all day here, but it's important to remember that if you don't invite everybody or everybody feels welcome, you are wasting potential.
Absolutely.
So the whole community will waste potential if not everybody feels welcome to contribute. So if you need a safe place to start to contribute, then the whole community will gain from it.
I agree. So I was going to ask you to what you said about that. Me and a couple of other guys from the hackerspace went to a math camp in England. That's a hacker camp. That was first time this year, and they had like these villages. From the, like, every hackerspace who was attending the event could have its own village, and which basically was a big tent or whatever, and then they could have workshops or whatever there. So, and one of my friends, he went into one of these villages from one of the hackerspaces, and he went in there, and nobody walked up to him and said, hi, what did you do? Like, how are you doing? We're doing this, and they invited him. This way. So, and he's really not a shy guy, so he usually walks in and talks to people and participates. But nobody kind of noticed him, or nobody went to talk to him, nobody invited him to participate, nobody showed him around. And we talked about this quite a lot later on. And so we totally want to avoid this situation when people come into our hackerspace. So we established a group of greeters to be there at the open meetings we have. And we have twice a week we have a meeting just open for everyone. And we always want at least one person or better to be there to kind of feel responsible to greet new people, to show them around, to explain how the space works. And this is obviously not just important for women, but for everyone. So to feel welcome and to feel okay, I might belong here. This is interesting. I can imagine coming back. So this is, actually I think this is a very, very important point.
I'd like to ask, what made you dumb? It sounds to me like Hackeriet is an especially good hackerspace. It sounds like
it is.
Yeah. I sort of get the impression that I haven't been there, but it seems like a very inviting place. So maybe, I mean, should you just have a really good social environment and then you will have women? Or is it?
There has to be something interesting happening as well. You know, it can't just be. The best times I've had at Hackeriet is when I've been at a workshop or inspiring talk, and it made me feel like, okay, I can come here, I can learn something, and I can ask for help if I need help. So I think that's very important. But it's also important, as we were talking about, like having a welcoming atmosphere.
So I think it's actually a combination of both. You get attention from new people by having interesting talks, workshops that you advertise, like along all kinds of channels. And then the people come there, and if they like the atmosphere, they come back. And if they don't feel welcome, and if they feel like, okay, yeah, this talk was kind of interesting, but then afterwards, everyone just sat there with their laptops, nobody was talking to me, and like kind of felt like, yeah, okay, so like, guess I'm leaving now, they won't come back, right? 5 minutes? Okay. Yeah, any last questions or comments? Yeah.
I was away for, I've seen like 5 or 10 minutes of your presentation here now, but we've started a hackerspace where I live in Sweden, Skarpnäck, Stockholm. And we have this setup where we meet once a week on Mondays, and every other week we have presentations, like just a normal presentation like this, of whatever topic that someone in the hackerspace wants to talk about, or that someone is interested about and someone else maybe can together a presentation about. And then every other week we have just like this casual hacking sessions. And what we noticed was that some people are very knowledgeable. I tend to count myself as very knowledgeable. And I think my first talk scared people away, because I'm going to do the same now in the Debian packaging workshop presentation that will be in next session in room 2. But it was so advanced for the people coming there, and they never came back. And it's so sad, because my goal is, I mean, all the people that are really knowledgeable can just come there, sit with their laptop, have their own projects, and be social with other super knowledgeable people. But it's very, very, I mean, that's not really the target audience for hackerspaces, I think. That's not where you need to put in effort. You need to put in effort for the ones that can engage themselves in activities. So what we've been thinking about is to have, like, Hedda, my partner, she has, are doing a basic workshop now. She does that all over Scandinavia so far. So the goal is to have basic Arduino workshops and basic Python workshops and stuff like this that newbies and also more knowledgeable people are interested in. And our one of the goals is, Hedda does the Arduino basic workshops women only. Well, not all of the time, but that's her goal, to get more women involved in free software and programming and embedded systems. So her thought with that in our hackerspace is to have like the workshop for Arduino basics for women only first, and then everyone else can partake also.
Yeah.
Because that sort of evens out all these the notions that we have that if I'm insecure, if I'm overconfident, that comes with the gender issues, and sort of evens it out if some people get the head start.
Mm. Sounds like a good recipe to me. And I would like to add one thing, which I think is helping. If before you start your talk, or can be the person who will do the talk or workshop or someone else, just work with everyone and tell them what you've planned for the next couple of weeks. Of course, this requires some kind of ahead planning. But you can also say, so we've been thinking about having this kind of talks and that kind of topic and workshops for this, for newbies, and talk for whatever, you know? Just let them know, okay, we're not just doing this very advanced Debian packages thing, but we're also doing like a bunch of other things, which you might be more interested in. Please come back, please check our website, please follow us on Twitter, please join our RSA channel, whatever. Because things are happening here, and even if you feel like, okay, today it was maybe not something for me, next week might be, or next month.
So if I can just add, we have that, since we're such a new hackerspace, we're like 1.5 or 2 months old. We have those discussions all the time, every time, because we don't really know what people are interested in or what people know, so we plan as we go all the time.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.